Hello everyone, I welcome you all on my channel. We are going to solve GATE 2015 questions on extractive metallurgy. We'll proceed with 1 mark, then we'll solve the 2 mark. So the first question is, in froth flotation, hydrophobic mineral particles. It is saying about hydrophobic mineral particle ascend with air bubbles preferentially over hydrophilic mineral particles. That means those particles which are hydrophobic in nature, that basically ascends with the air bubbles. Okay, and those which are hydrophilic, those get attached to water, is not going to preferentially ascend with the air bubble, right? The figure below shows a schematic of a water droplet placed on the surfaces of two mineral P and Q. So one is mineral P and another is mineral Q. And this is the water bubble, right? And the next is air. So if you see here, in the case of mineral P, the water is in the form of a bubble, and if you see the attachment of mineral P with water, it is less. And in the case of mineral Q, the water is spread over a larger surface. That means the water here attachment is more. That means it is wettable, but it is not wettable. And since this is a wettable, that means this one is hydrophilic, and this one will be what? Hydrophobic, means it is not going to get attached with water. So that means the mineral P has got the higher tendency to float with air bubble, right? Because it is not getting attached to water molecule, so it will get attached to air, and basically it will ascend. So mineral P ascends with air bubble preferentially over mineral Q. Option A is the correct answer here, right? Now let us move to next question. Which of the following oxide addition results in polymerization, that is network formation, in a silicate slag? Okay. So it is basically asking about the network formation oxide which is there. We know that a silicate slag, that is basically consist of SiO4 4-, right? Silicate slag, it forms network, right? It forms like a tetrahedral network. Now when we add non-metallic oxide, like here it is given P2O5. So what happens whenever this type of non-metallic oxide is there, so this also forms chain. It forms chain. And what is the chain structure here? It is like PO4 3-, right? So it get attached with this one and thus helps in network formation. So here only the non-metallic oxide is going to help in network formation. So C will be your correct answer. Now what are the roles of CaO or MgO or Na2O in silicate slag? So basically these act as the network breaker. How it acts? Like we have SiO4 4-, that means we can write it as like this. right? Now, whenever we add like CaO, then this CaO dissociates like CO2 plus and O2 minus, right? So what happens? This CO2 plus one get attached to one gets attached to one molecule and O2 minus gets attached to another molecule, right? And like this, it helps to break basically. It forms something like this. So this helps in breaking. Okay, so all metallic oxide like CaO, MgO or Na2O will play the same role of breaking, right? So you got the difference. Okay, now let us move to next question. Zinc is commercially extracted from which of the following mineral? So what is the mineral of zinc? We know it is ZnS, right? And ZnS is called as sphalerite. So ZnS, that means sphalerite, is the ore through which we extract zinc commercially. Magnetite, what is magnetite? Fe3O4. Chalcopyrite, you know, CuFeS2. Then galena, we know, PbS. So this is ore of lead, this is ore of copper, and this is iron. So what will be your answer? Sphalerite. Okay, next, self-supporting arcs for furnace roofs can be fabricated using silica bricks but not using magnesia bricks. Why? Let us read the options first. Silica has a significantly lower thermal expansion coefficient than magnesia at high temperature. Okay, silica has a significantly higher thermal conductivity than magnesia at high temperature. Okay, silica has a significantly lower melting point than magnesia. Silica is significantly more acidic than magnesia. Okay, it is asking about self-supporting arcs for furnace roofs. Suppose this is a furnace. This is furnace, and it is talking about the roof, right? So this is made of silica, that means SiO2. And why it is not made of magnesia? It is asking about magnesia, right? That means MgO, right? Now, the correct option is that here at this position there will be tremendous amount of heat which will flow from the base to the top, right? It will contain the gases and the heat will be dissipated. So this portion will be under tremendous amount of heat, right? And it is seen that in silica, the thermal conductivity in silica, the coefficient of expansion, the coefficient of thermal expansion is very low. It varies in the range of 0.52 × 10⁻⁶ per Kelvin, right? I have got data from some source, and the magnesia, if you see, the magnesia has got the thermal coefficient of thermal expansion as 9 × 10⁻⁶. So you can see here that SiO2 has got the lower coefficient of thermal expansion. That means it is not going to expand much, and since it is not going to expand, so while cooling, so it is not going to again contract much. That means the silica bricks which will be at the top will not form any kind of crack. But if you use magnesia, then because of this high thermal coefficient of thermal expansion, it will crack, right? It will have the tendency to crack basically. So that is not the requirement. So option A will be your correct answer, right? Now let us move to next question. These are 2 marks question. First question: carbon plus CO2 gives 2 CO, right? Is an important reaction in iron making. Given delta H0 298 equal to 172,000 joules per mole of CO2, okay, which of the following conditions will favor the forward reaction? So let us first write the reaction here. 2CO. It is in gas, it is in gas, and here it is in solid. We know delta G0 equal to delta H0 minus T into delta S0. And here delta S0 is given 172,000 minus T into delta S0, let it be, right? We don't know about delta S0. Now it is asking about that, what are the conditions that will favor the reaction. So whenever the reaction will be favored, that means delta G should be negative, right? So delta H0 is a positive term, right? So this has to be negative. That means to be negative, delta H0 should be positive, right? Then only this complete term will be negative, and it should be higher than delta H0 in negative, so that the overall equation will be such that delta G0 will be negative, right? Okay, so here if you see delta S0, so delta S0 basically S product minus S reactant, right? So in the product we have 2 mole of CO, right? And in the reactant we have only 1 mole of CO and CO2 and 1 mole of carbon, that is in solid state. So entropy that can be taken as 0 over there. So basically 2 mole in the product side will have more entropy than the 1 mole in the reactant. So overall it will be positive, right? Now this delta S0 being positive, you know, when we increase the temperature, then entropy also increases, right? So entropy will increase. So this entropy increase will basically favor the reaction, because as the entropy increases, that means delta S0 increases, that means delta G0 becomes negative, right? So one condition, it is clear that temperature should increase, right? So first one, temperature should increase. What will be the second? It is talking about the pressure, right? Now suppose we increase the pressure over here, we increase the total pressure. So whenever we increase the total pressure, then if you see in this reaction, in the product side we have 2 mole of CO and in the reactant side we have only 1 mole of CO2. So since there are 2 moles of CO, so when we increase the pressure, then pressure in the reactant side will increase, and pressure in the, sorry, whenever we increase the pressure, then the pressure in the product side will increase and pressure in the reactant side will decrease, because there are 2 moles of CO. So that will favor the backward reaction, okay? So increase in pressure is going to favor the backward reaction. So that means we'll have to decrease the pressure. So which is the option? Increasing temperature and decreasing pressure, right? So option D is the correct answer, right? Okay, you got this? Next question. Consider the reaction Fe3O4 solid pure state plus CO gas 1 atm pressure gives 3 FeO solid pure P plus CO2, right? This is the reaction. For this reaction, delta G0 equal to minus 8000 joules per mole of CO, and R is equal to 8.314 joule per mole per Kelvin. The equilibrium ratio PCO2 by PCO for the reaction at 1200 Kelvin and 1 atm is, okay, so the reaction it is taking about at 1200 Kelvin, right? We have the reaction here. Let me write again. We know delta G0 equal to minus RT ln K, and delta G0 at 1200 it is given. Okay, so delta G0 is equal to minus 8.314 and temperature is 1200 and ln K. Ln K will be partial pressure of CO2 divided by partial pressure of CO, and let me write here activity of FeO to the power 3 in the denominator, it will be activity of Fe3O4, and here it is given these are solid and it is in pure state, so activity will be taken as 1, right? So delta G0 is equal to minus 8000 is equal to minus 8.314 into 1200 ln PCO2 by PCO, right? To do the calculation, so here everything is written over here, you just need to calculate. So after calculation, you will find that PCO2 by PCO will be equal to 2.2, right? 2.22 basically. Okay, so this is your answer. Okay, now let us move to next question. An iron blast furnace produces hot metal containing 95% iron. Okay, the iron ore charge into the furnace contains 95% Fe2O3 and the rest is gangue. Assume that all the iron in the ore goes to hot metal. The amount of iron ore in kg required for producing 1000 kg of hot metal is. Okay, now so this is a problem of basically material balance or mass balance. Here the steel making process is there, and we are putting ore and we are getting what? Hot metal, right? So in the ore we are putting Fe2O3, and it is such that it contains only 95%. 5% it contains gangue, right? And hot metal it contains 95% iron, right? So whatever the iron which we get from ore is getting converted or getting inside the hot metal, right? So we need to balance the iron. It is simple. Now the hot metal amount it is given here, it is 1000 kg, right? Okay, so we need to find the what is the amount of iron ore. So let it be X. So since 95% only contains Fe2O3, so what will be the content of Fe2O3 first into X, right? This will be the amount of Fe2O3, and what is the amount of Fe in Fe2O3? So it will be, according to molecular concept, it will be 56 into 2. 56 is the atomic weight of iron, okay, divided by 56 into 2 plus oxygen, we know it is 16 into 3, right? So this will give you the molar mass percent of Fe. So this complete Fe is going into the hot metal. So hot metal contain 95%, that means 95 by 100, and what is the amount of hot metal? It is 1000 kg, right? Okay, fine. So this is the mass balance equation over here. Okay, so now if you do the calculation, you can find directly here. So if you do calculation, so it will be x will be 1428.57, right? And here hot metal is in kg, so all balancing is in kg, so this x will be in kg, right? So x equal to, that means the amount of iron ore, it is 1428.57 kg. Now let us move to next question. Match the metals listed in group 1 with the most appropriate extraction routes listed in group 2. In group 1 we have the metals aluminium, titanium, copper and iron, and these are the processes of their manufacturing or extraction, right? So we know that aluminium is extracted using electrolysis method, right? So it will be electrolysis of fused salt, right? Titanium, it is extracted using Kroll process, right? So what is there in the Kroll process? That titanium chloride is reacted with magnesium to form MgCl2 and pure titanium, and it is in a sponge form. So some kind of halide is involved here. So this comes under halide metallurgy, right? So titanium will match with 4. Copper, we know copper extraction takes place through the matte smelting. How? Because we know copper contains CuFeS2O. So we do first the roasting, right? So it forms something like copper oxide and FeO. Okay. Then in the next stage we go for matte smelting. In the matte smelting we produce matte basically, and this matte is of CuS, right? CuS. And the last is the iron. So iron, we know it is manufactured or extracted using blast furnace, right? So it is simple. So P matches with 3, so P matches with 3, Q matches with 4. So P matches with 3, Q matches with 4, option B here, and R matches with 2. So 2, it is also matching, S matches with 1. So option B is the correct answer, right guys? Now let us move to next question. The figure below shows the cumulative size distribution of particles of a crushed mineral. 10 kg of this mineral is first passed through a sieve of 400 micron and then through a sieve of 300 micron. The weight of mineral that is retained on the 300 micron size is. Guys, for this problem, you need to understand that if you see here, for the 900 micrometer particle size, if the particle size is 900 micrometer, right, is whenever the sieve size is such that the particle size of 900 micrometer, so it is basically passing through the sieve, right? So whenever the particle size it decreases, the amount of retention changes. So here it is, suppose 90% is there, that means 90% is going inside and 10% it is on the outside. That means 100 minus 90, 10% it is there, 10%, that means 1 kg is over here, right? So similarly from here to here the change is 10% again, 10%, that means 1 kg is retained over here again, right? So similarly, so when it reaches to the 400, the amount, the total amount which is going to remain here, the total here, it will be above this 400, it will be 6 kg, right? So 100 minus 40 here, so 6 kg it will be. Now, and the amount of particle which is going to be above 300, it will be how much? 100 minus 10, that means 90%, that means 9 kg, right? So 9 kg of mineral is going to be above 300 micrometer size, and 6 kg is going to be above 400. So what will be in between? It will be 9 minus 6, that means 3 kg. Okay, so thank you all. Hope this will help you in your GATE preparation.